I would like to ask the President of European Federation on NDT, Matthias Pruschke, to say about this conference. Who is organizer of this conference?
Thank you very much, Zdeněk, for this kind introduction. Well, distinguished guests, distinguished presidents of the national NDT societies and international federation and committees, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 11th ECNDT and welcome to Prague. On behalf of the organizer of this conference and of EFNDT's board of directors, I want to say we are very grateful to have the opportunity to welcome you, participants from all over the world. Thank you very much for attending this conference here in the capital of the Czech Republic, here in Prague. The chairman of the scientific committee of this 11th ECNDT has already presented the figures of the conference. And I must say, these figures are very, very impressive, because it clearly shows that this event is not just an European event. It is an international event with worldwide attendance. The large number of submitted papers, the great interest of exhibitors, and the strong commitment of our sponsors shows the importance of this event for the worldwide NDT community. And this makes us proud. And in particular, the organizer of this event, the Czech society, can be very proud. It is a result of their hard work since 2009, and everybody who organized such an event knows how much effort and power it requires. Even for large societies, the organization of such an international event is a huge challenge. For smaller societies, and I think or I hope our Czech colleagues will not be embarrassed, the Czech society is a smaller society. For those smaller societies, this challenge is tremendous. And only with strong personal commitment, such a task can be managed. Therefore, I want to say congratulations and many thanks to the Czech Society for NDT for their strong commitment to make this event to a success. Thank you very much. Today I want to take the opportunity to give you a brief introduction and the aims and goals of the European Federation for NDT, and let's start with some historical facts. The Federation, it has been founded in 1996, and the origins in the European Council, founded in 1984. Maybe more important is the EFNDT is a non-for-profit legal entity registered in Brussels. And what is the aim? The aim is to increase the influence at the European level. Now we have 32 member societies and 7 associate members. I will come back to that a little bit later. And the EFNDT is also one of the 4 regional groups, or regional federations of the International Committee for NDT. The others are being America, Asia Pacific, and Africa. Actually, our mission statement clearly describes what EFNDT is standing for. It is a Europe-wide partnership to promote NDT and related fields for the benefit of industry, the professions, the users, and the wider community. This mission statement is completed by the EFNDT values and principles, which gives a more detailed impression of the aims and goals, and I just want to give you some keywords. And very important EFNDT value is that the members are dedicated to the public safety and to the public safety in a technological world. The members promote the value of NDT and related topics, in particular the certification of NDT personnel, to which I will also come back a little bit later. The members shall promote as a valuable instrument the assurance of competence through accreditation, training and certification. Members consider that knowledge about NDT and related topics will be strengthened, harmonized and disseminated by means of conferences like today, symposia, publications and other media. Members will strive to make certification processes equivalent throughout Europe. Maybe one of the more important topics and values and principles. Let's say a few words about the membership criteria. To gain the full membership, must be an NDT society in Europe, a non-for-profit legal entity, and EFNDT accepts only one NDT society per country. To become an associate member, it must also be a non-profit organization with an interest in NDT, but that's not limited to Europe. The organization of the European Federation is simple and straightforward. The work is organized in committees, working groups, and forums, dealing with the technical questions on the European level. The General Assembly elects the board, the treasurer, the vice president, and the president. And just a word, how does a board of directors look like today? We have voting members from Hungary, Belgium, United Kingdom, Slovenia, France, Russia, Spain, Austria, and the Ukraine. And non-voting members from Croatia, the past president Vera Krusel, from the Czech Republic, the ECNDT president Pavel Mazal, the secretary from Germany, Jutta Köhn, Emilio Romero from Spain, Patrick Falloway from France, and David Gilbert, our communications secretary from the United Kingdom. I think this personal setting shows indeed that all regional aspects of the European NDT are well represented at the board. And this is actually a good moment to say thank you to the chairman and conveners of our committees, working groups and forums, and to the board for their voluntary commitment to the EFNDT. My special thanks, of course, go to the board members for their continuous support. Many thanks for that. What are our current activities? Don't worry, I don't want to go too much in detail. I just want to highlight some of the major activities. And a key activity, without any doubt, is still NDT personal certification. And several activities are going on. Actually, the transition of the European Standard 473 to EN ISO 9712 are more or less completed. The Certification Executive Committee, of course, now must think about the future of the EFNDT Mutual Recognition Agreement. We have Global Qualification, Global Certification Standard. There is an ICNDT MIA on the way. And of course, the EFNDT MIA signatories have the choice to move to the ICNDT MIA. We have to think about the advancements of EFNDT MIA, and we have also to use a chance given by the fact that the EFNDT is a recognized stakeholder of the European Corporation for Accreditation. Our forums and working groups are the technical backbone of our organization. They provide a platform for discussion of matters of common technical interest and provide also formal representation of the common interests and concerns to European institutions. The European NDT quality guidelines, called the overall NDT quality system, have been issued in 2008. And I think we can say they have set all over the years the scene for all aspects of the so-called NDT quality infrastructure. This brochure probably has been the most successful print work we, the EFNDT, have ever published. Therefore, I'm really happy to announce that a second issue of the guideline is now available. The second issue covers the new situation with the revised standards, EN ISO IEC 70024, issued in 2012, and of course also for EN ISO 9712. It is the first time presented here at the ECNDT in Prague. Thanks to all who contributed to the second issue. And actually, no, it was a moment where I wanted to say, get your free copy at the EFNDT booth, but it seems to be that we had some issues, problems on the way from the print company here to the exhibition. Hopefully it will arrive. Check it out, come to the EFNDT booth, and hopefully you will get your free copy there. Of course, this event, this EFNDT guidelines are also playing a very important role for the promotion of NDT for safety. Promotion of NDT for safety on the European stage or on the European level, this, of course, is indeed a major goal of the European Federation for NDT. We are doing this in case-to-case cooperation with related European institutions and federations like Eurolab, CEOC, EAN, the European ELARA Network, the International Atomic Energy Agency, IAEA, and the European Welding Federation, and some more. This item of my talk gives me the opportunity to welcome once again our colleagues from ASNT. Thank you for coming. Your attendance is really appreciated. Since a long time, we have a very good, well-grown, and trustful liaison with ASNT. Sometimes we have different point of views, but the relationship between ASNT and EFNDT has always been distinguished by mutual acknowledgement and understanding. And this makes our liaison so valuable, stable, and important. Thank you for that. We have regular informal meetings to exchange our experiences and information. And the next one will be held at the ASNT Fall Conference in Charleston. And we are looking forward to another fruitful coming meeting. Now, being close to the end of my presentation, I want to come back to the European Conference for Non-Destructive Testing. The European Conference has always been a very important activity of the former European Council and of today's European Federation for NDT. Actually, the foundation of the former Council and today's Federation has its roots in the European Conference for NDT. Anything started in 1978, with the first conference in Germany, and then you can see any 3 years a conference followed, next one, 81 in Vienna, and so on. We had 1984, it's a ECNDT in Florence, we had the foundation of the European Council, and at the end, in 1998, in Copenhagen, we founded the European Federation for Non-Destructive Testing. This shows the long tradition of the European Conference, each with particular highlights and with a particular focus, but always following our common goal. NDT for a safe world, and better NDT for an even safer world. And exactly this is a headline chosen by our Czech colleagues for the 11th European Conference 2014 in Prague. Better NDT, warranty of quality, reliability, and safety. I'm quite sure this 11th European Conference is going to be another milestone in the meanwhile long history of the European conferences. And dear colleagues, in this sense, let us learn what the newest developments are. Let us exchange what the newest experiences are. Let us talk about common issues. Let us strengthen our old friendships. Let us find new friendships. Or simply said, let us enjoy the European Conference 2014 here in Prague. Thank you very much for your attention.